Hi, welcome back to another Heather Mac Reacts. Today we're going through some Am I the A-hole stories. And if you like videos like this, make sure you subscribe because I post 5 times a week, every single week. Now, if you're ready, I'm ready. Let's get into this first Am I the A-hole story. This says, am I the A-hole for misusing my inheritance from my grandma? Did you spend it on hookers and drugs? Because other than that, I don't know how you can misuse your own freaking money, but let's see what the story says. My 30 female, my grandma passed away a little over a year ago now. She raised my twin sister, Kate, and I ever since our parents died when we were 6. She was a kind, generous, and loving to us during our childhood. Even so, she was a devout Christian and firmly against the LGBTQ community. That's funny because doesn't the Bible say, love thy neighbor, not as long as they're heterosexual? But okay, I knew I was gay from the start. Luckily, I had many good friends and adult figures in my life that helped me. They all agreed that I shouldn't tell my grandma. My grandpa died years ago, but left a substantial amount of life insurance money. She used that to support my sister and I. She encouraged us to go to college and offered to pay in full. My sister and I weren't close, but not enemies either. That makes me sad. They're twins. I will cry a million tears if my boys are not close. We just have different personalities. She's similar to my grandma, so they were actually a lot closer to each other than me. I came out to Kate when we were 16. She didn't approve of it, but never told my grandma anything. We had a silent understanding. Kate got a degree, moved back to our hometown, and became a stay-at-home mom after she met her husband and had a kid. Grandma lived with them, so Kate cared for her. I'm now a lawyer and live in a big city. My grandma was proud, but kept pushing me to find a husband and have kids like my sister. I told her I hadn't found the right guy yet, right up until she died. I have a fiance, Jen, 31 female, who I've been dating for 2.5 years. In the last 3 years of her life, grandma was very ill and didn't want to stress her out anymore with me coming out. I just told her that Jen was my best friend. Grandma left an impressive amount of inheritance for me and Kate to split 50-50. Me and Jen also plan to spend about $36,000 for our dream wedding and another $10,000 for a perfect honeymoon. Yes, I know that sounds ridiculous to some people, but we have our reasons. Ain't my money, ain't my problem. Grandma's will requested we donate $10,000 to a charity of our choice. I chose a charity in our area that helps endangered LGBTQ plus youths. The rest we're investing towards retirement and putting towards a down payment on a home. I was telling Kate about the wedding plans. She asked how I had the funds for them. I told her it was grandma's inheritance. She was upset by this. She yelled about how while I had gone off to live my own sinful life, she did what any good granddaughter would, took care of grandma and raised a family. Okay, so you went ahead and spent your grandma's money for a degree and then decided to turn around and be a stay-at-home mom and raise the kids and take care of your grandma. What was the point of the degree? Why were you wasting her money on that? If you were just gonna be a good grandma and raise a good granddaughter and raise a family. She said she deserved much more than half the inheritance since she has a kid and cared for grandma the most before her death. She mentioned the charity, so I confessed that it was an LGBTQ one. But she loved that. She said, I'm dancing on grandma's grave by doing these things with her hard-earned money that I know she'd dislike. She left and said she won't be coming to my wedding. So long, sucker. I asked some friends what they think. They said it was still my grandma's money. To spend it on something she would hate is disrespectful. Jen suggested to use the money for something else and save up for our wedding to keep the peace. We both have good jobs, so it is something we could accomplish, even if it would take a little while. Now Kate won't answer my calls. I'm wondering if what I planned was insensitive. I liked the idea of this gift from her would be a way to start off my new page in life, but I truly loved my grandmother despite our differences. I'm wondering if this has gone too far and I should just save up for the things I want and use her money for just a house / retirement funds. Am I the a-hole? Gonna say again, you're not spending this money on drugs and gambling and alcohol and depravity, don't care. You're spending it on starting your life with the person that you love. And it's not your problem that your grandmother wouldn't approve of who you love. you're not being insensitive and you're not the a-hole. There's an edit. I figured I might as well add why the wedding will be so expensive. A good amount of Jen's relatives live in France, including both sets of her grandparents. They, and even some of the younger family members, have various health issues that would make it either impossible or extremely stressful to fly to America for the wedding. Jen is very close to all of them, so we want them there no matter what, so our wedding will be a destination one near Paris. It's fairly small, but of course we understand how expensive travel slash childcare can be. We both have good jobs, so we want to pay for the guest tickets, hotel rooms, and basically help them out any way we can so they can attend. I'll admit the honeymoon money is for some luxury fun. Girl, go off, do your thing. It's absolutely not your sister's business. It's not your grandma's business. And from what I recall, it wasn't even your grandma's hard-earned money. It was your grandfather's hard-earned money. So not her freaking business either. Let's see what the comments say. Speaking as an old guy that's been married a couple of times, one, it's your inheritance, your money. Do what you want with it. But at your age, you'd be wise to invest or save for retirement. I'm saying this as I will not be able to retire until age 72 and I'm 66 and tired now. Get it. I get it. Don't spend so much on the wedding ceremony, but splurge on the honeymoon. In years to come, you won't remember crap about the ceremony, but you'll have great memories of that honeymoon trip, and that's without regard to being straight or LGBTQ+. Understood. Next comment says, I'll third this. Not the a-hole for spending how she wants, but absolutely fuck spending that much on a wedding. Fly to France, have a small ceremony. I get why she wants to spend that much on her wedding, and it's her money to do with what she wants. Like I said, she's not spending it on human trafficking or selling drugs. She's spending it on starting her life with the person that she loves. So hopefully wherever her grandma is, she's lost her bigotry and her backwards thinking and would understand that love is love is love is love. Those are my thoughts. I'd like to know what you think in the comments, and let's get on to the next story. This says, am I the hole? Mom doesn't let us bring our dogs to their home anymore. I'm gonna suspend my opinion for a second here, but I will say if it's not your home, it's not your choice. But let's see what the story says. For the past 7 years, I have had a black lab that has been allowed to every family function. He is well-trained and doesn't make any messes. This past year, my brother and I got puppies from the same litter, golden retrievers. Little did I know how much these dogs shed and how much energy siblings have whenever they get together. My mother is a clean freak. She is the type of person who finds joy in cleaning and making sure her home is perfect, is in perfect condition every time someone walks through their door. Recently, my parents lost their Shih Tzu, and ever since, my mom has stated that dogs are no longer allowed at the house. I think she is being completely unreasonable because we cannot leave our dogs alone for hours on end, 8+, during holidays and family get-togethers. She claims that it is fine and they are dogs and won't do too much while we are away. I think she's being over the top about cleanliness and needs to get over it due to the fact that these dogs aren't going anywhere for at least 10+ years. And what about when me and my wife want kids and they make messes? Do we have to leave them at home with the dogs? Am I the hole for thinking my mom is being unreasonable? First of all, millions of people leave their dogs home alone for 8+ hours a day while they go the fuck to work. Not everyone can afford a doggy daycare. So get a grip. Your dogs will be fine. If you're worried about what they'll do in your house, then you can crate train them. And once again, they'll be fine. Second of all, I get her not wanting dog hair and dander and dirt in her house after she no longer has a dog. Like, let me tell you something. It's been a rule since we moved to this house that no dogs are on my couch. I don't want dog hair on my couch. I don't want dog hair where I'm sitting. I don't want dog hair all over my clothes. So the dogs can sleep on their beds and I will sit on my couch. That is the way I like to do things in my house, and that is my right because I pay the bills. So yeah, if your mom doesn't want freaking dogs at her house, you need to just respect that and get a fucking grip. That's my opinion. Let's see, there are edits. One, I appreciate the input here from everyone. Glad to have a community put the ego in check. 2, didn't expect to get this much attention. I appreciate the input from everyone taking the time to comment and give me a perspective on her thought process, but I don't need to be berated for wanting to spend time with family and have the dogs there at the same time. Some of you are really comfortable behind the keyboard. Bro, you brought this to Reddit. What did you expect? 3, we do have accommodations for our dogs most of the time with my in-laws. This year they are joining us for the holidays, so that makes this a little more complicated. I understand that they can be on their own for multiple hours. My lab has done it for years. It's just when the puppies are together, they get a little rambunctious. Yeah, and your mom shouldn't have to deal with that. 4, forgot to mention, brother will be out of state for the holidays, so I'm watching their dog as well. 5, this is only for holidays. Normal dinners and functions are 1 to 4 hours. I'm fine leaving the dogs at home. It's when they want us to spend the night over there and drink heavily, it becomes harder to make accommodations. I leave the dogs at home for a few hours all the time. Final edit, I think this gives a skewed version of the relationship with my family. There is no animosity and I am not mad at her for setting a boundary. But you brought this to Reddit. If anything, it just caught me off guard after multiple family and friend functions where the dogs were allowed. Some of my wording in the original post may have been over the top, painting this to be a much bigger issue. Of course, I respect their home and their want for cleanliness. Final edit, I may indeed be the a-hole. Glad you got there eventually. Let's see what the comment says. You are the a-hole. She let your dogs over and now she won't. It's her house, man. Honestly, never a fan when people feel they have to bring their pets everywhere. Unless it's a service dog, you really shouldn't have to be bringing it to every occasion you attend. They should absolutely be fine for a few hours at home, to be honest. And by you're the a-hole, I mean you're not exactly an a-hole. You love your pet, their family, but not everyone wants your pet at their house every time they want to see you. Get a grip. It's not your house. It's not your choice. It's not your decision. That's what I think. I would like to know what you think about that one in the comments. And let's get on to the next story. This says, am I the hole for telling my mom if she wanted to help, she'd do the one thing I'm asking? I'm not so sure. You get to dictate the type of help you get, but Reddit says they're not the a-hole. So let's see what we think. I'm 20 female. Myself and my 4-week-old daughter recently left an undesirable situation and we have almost nothing. I have a handful of clothes for my daughter and some necessities. This place we're staying provides food but nothing else, and the charity available to me is very backed up at the moment. My mom is swearing she'll help me in any way possible. My daughter is growing out of her clothes. I only have one spare outfit and none of my own necessities. I've asked my mom if her and my dad would be able to return to my house and get me a few bits of mine, including clothes for both of us, some cash I had hidden, my iPad, which I use for college so I don't fall further behind and get kicked out, and my daughter's stroller and bassinet. Reasonable. My mom came up with a lot of excuses, such as she doesn't have time, or she's got plans every day for the next week, or my dad is working, but she does want to help. My mom would drop every single thing she had going on to help me out in a situation like this. I've been really stressed over the last number of days, and I ended up lashing out at my mother and told her, shut up, because you keep telling me you want to help me. Did y'all hear that? Okay, baby, give mommy 1 minute. I'll be right there, okay? Shut up, because you keep telling me you want to help me, but if you really wanted to, you'd do the one thing I'm asking and not just say you want to help like everyone else. She got really upset and she's doing her best, to which I replied, you're not doing anything. How is that your best? She's not speaking to me at the moment, and my dad is angry at me for snapping at my mom. He thinks I'm an a-hole because she was trying to help me and I lashed out at her over it. I'm really not sure how to feel right now because my head and hormones are all over the place. Am I the a-hole? No, it's not like, okay, see when you said like, oh, I want her to help me in this certain way but not in other ways, I was thinking you were gonna say, oh, she's like buying me all new stuff but I really want her to get my old stuff. Like, you're getting help, you don't need to be picky about the help you're getting. But from the sound of your story, you're not getting any effing help, so it's not like you're picking and choosing what help you're getting. You're not getting any freaking help. Again, my mother lives 8 states away in New York. It's an 8.5-hour drive. If I were to be in a similar situation, she would drop every single thing she had, hop on a plane, the first plane she could find, fly her ass down here and do whatever I needed, because she would know her daughter was in a situation that was dire. That's what moms do for their kids. Don't know what this mom is on or what her freaking issue is, but she is not being a very helpful mother. Let's see what the comment says. Wow, the amount of you are the a-hole votes on here is outrageous. Come on, Reddit. My ex was not a nice person, and my parents still don't know the entire story 2 years later. But I called my dad the second I got broken up with over text, and my dad picked me up from work, took me back to the apartment, and wouldn't allow my ex near me as I grabbed essentials for the next few days. And then both of my parents, my brother, and my dad's best friend helped me completely get all of my stuff out 2 days later. It's what family does when they actually care. And yes, my ex was a threat to me. My dad didn't care. My dad had and still has my back and has always been my go-to person in a crisis and will continue to be so. I didn't realize other people couldn't count on their family like I can. How sad. Edited to add judgment, not the a-hole. I completely agree. I don't know what the hell is wrong with your mom, but something severe. I want to know what you think about that one in the comments, and let's get on to our next story. Okay, this says, am I the a-hole for not making or bringing a child-appropriate cake to sister-in-law's birthday? What exactly is a child-appropriate cake? I mean, was the cake that they brought like shaped like a penis? Because that's not really child-appropriate. If they know what penises are, if they're really little, who cares, right? Cake is cake. This sounds silly, but let's see what the story says. It's my sister-in-law's 35th birthday. She is a lovely baker. She makes cakes for everyone else's occasions. I've noticed this is never reciprocated. She gets a shop-bought cake, apparently because of her impossibly high standards. Although from what I have seen, she is very polite, so even if she felt she could do better, she would never say. I sent a message saying we would bring the cake. I made a white chocolate raspberry cake with white chocolate ganache, no alcohol or anything, just white chocolate raspberries and a shit ton of calories. Do you, boo-boo? Other sister-in-law made a snarky comment about what's wrong with vanilla, but she's like that, so I just ignored her. Next day, I got a text which read, in future, if you're going to make a cake that is not kid-friendly, would you please bring a second cake or at least let us know, as nephew was so upset to not get any cake at his auntie's birthday party. I responded with, she has been posting passive-aggressive memes on Facebook all day. I mean, is this a thing? I would kind of get it if I had soaked the sponges in amaretto or something, which is why I didn't make a hazelnut cake. But even then, is it my responsibility? I honestly don't see how I can possibly be the a-hole because an 11-year-old only likes a plain cake. So just checking, am I the a-hole? No. Is it your job as the bringer of one cake to make sure every single person at this party likes the cake that you brought? No, those are called personal preferences, and they're personal preferences, so the person has to deal with them. It's not like it was the nephew's birthday and you brought a cake that he wouldn't eat. That would be shitty. Where do these people get off, or where do they get these ideas that like every single person and all their feelings should be accounted for? Get a grip. Let's see what the comment says. I just am laughing at this. Oh, sorry, there's an edit. A couple of things being brought up. One, I didn't notice if nephew did or did not eat the cake. I only have sister-in-law's word for it, which is not much to go on. She can lean to the hysterical and see slights in everything. He might have eaten it and not liked it, or he might not have. Two, I didn't know nephew would be there. Birthday sister-in-law and our kids, all under four, weren't. And after I said I'd sort cake in the GC, I messaged sister-in-law's partner for numbers. He said seven, so I assumed birthday sister-in-law plus partner, sister-in-law plus partner, stepfather-in-law, and us. She is not with nephew's dad, so it's not unreasonable to think he wouldn't be there. Three, I picked the cakes because it's easy to make. Sister-in-law made a similar cheesecake previously, so I assumed she would like it. So this isn't the birthday sister-in-law who's complaining. This is the other bitch sister-in-law who has no right to say a goddamn thing. The Facebook posts are heavily suggesting she wants an apology, LOL. And we are taking bets between my husband and I as how long before his dad messages us to tell us it's expected. She was babysitting our kids, so wasn't there. He was babysitting our kids, so wasn't there. Birthday sister-in-law has a different dad. I suspect she tried to have the restaurant changed to a more kid-friendly one and was declined, as she's done that before. So, as not to be a witch to the birthday girl, she is taking it out on me. Oh well. The recipe, if anyone is interested, is a BBC Good Food website. If you Google white chocolate raspberry cake plus BBC, it should come up. Don't care, more edit. Because it has come up a few times, I have no reason to think nephew wasn't invited. I never asked who would be there, just how many, and assumed he would be at his dad's. Birthday sister-in-law's dad wasn't coming, which is why it was 7 and not 8. Yeah, not every guest's preferences are supposed to be taken into consideration when you make a freaking cake for a party. Unless it's like an allergy, especially if there's like 8 people at the party, like yeah, you would be concerned with an allergy, but it's not your job to make sure every single freaking person likes the cake that you bring. What the actual hell? Let's see what the comments say. Not the a-hole. Other sister-in-law is cuckoo bananas. There's nothing about that cake that's inherently un-kid friendly. It sounds delicious. Next said, but even if it wasn't, is it customary to bring a second cake for the kids? This is not something my family will do, so I'm confused. That was the OP. Next says, my 5-year-old would go bananas for that cake. Your other sister-in-law is just jealous. You made a cake that properly reciprocated all the times the birthday sister-in-law made cakes for everyone else. I would bet money that the sister-in-law complaining is the one that just always caught the sheet cake. You are not the a-hole. Yeah, I mean, you brought a freaking cake to a party. Sorry the 8-year-old has specific tastes, but that sounds like a his mom problem and a no one else's problem. That's my feelings on the matter. I would like to know what you think in the comments. Don't forget, we have a playlist of, maybe we're at a 200 at this point. I can't do math. Playlist of other Am I the A-hole videos up here that you can binge. Please don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.